Hello there, my lovelies. For today's video, I will be doing a freestyle chakra painting for you guys. So, today I'll be using Pebbio Studio acrylic colours, some craft ink, which I have just a little bit left. Of course, my trusty soft paint brushes, and also some colouring pencils towards the end. So here I've got a couple of reference pictures to give me some inspiration and ideas on how to correctly draw each chakra symbol. So I'll just pop those to one side for the time being. I'm using a watercolor paper from my A3 pad. So, first I'm going to start on the backdrop. Now, I have an idea in my head of what I would like it to look like, but it doesn't always go the way I plan. So, we will see. But I invite you all to join me on this little inspirational painting journey. To start, I'm using my watered down Pebbio acrylics. So I will start with my favourite colour, purple. As always, and I'll be using the colours from the reference image next to me to give me an idea. Okay. So I'm just feathering out and watering down the edges so they blend better, and adding more colour in the centre because I really want the background to pop so you guys can see each colour. Okay, add a bit more water and just drag it down. Okay. Make sure the paper is nice and soaked for my next colour. Okay. So I'm just going to start adding a little bit of my sort of more indigo and blues. Gradually blend it in with my purple. So, ideally, I want it to look very cloud and mist-like. So, I hope that comes across. Now at this stage, obviously I'm not trying to be neat about it because I just wanted a colour wash over the background, and you'll notice I'm not using the colour to fill the background. I just want it as, I guess, a shape or a hint of something behind my main foreground, because I don't like having white backgrounds to my pieces. It just distracts me too much. Okay. I love how the colours bleed together. It's really therapeutic as well to watch them. So, we're looking for almost a watercolour consistency. Just about, or an ink wash. So, I'm dragging the blue down slightly further, and that is to hopefully help me blend the green into it a lot smoother. So, as with any wash background, the key is layering. If it looks too strong, just dilute it, and once it's dry, if you're not happy with your colour, just do what I do and add another layer. It's really simple, and it's something you'll see later on in the video when I have let this piece dry. I will go back over it to give it a bit more vibrancy. At the moment, it doesn't look like anything particularly special, but reminds me a little bit of an island. Okay. So for this part, I've used two greens that I'm mixing together, and the ink is much more bright green, I'd say, much more lighter. And the darker shade is the Pebbio acrylic. So, I wanted the backdrop to go into a sort of organic sweeping motion, if that makes sense. I just wanted it to sort of spiral down to the bottom. And I will fill it out a little bit later in the video, but for now I just wanted to get the basic sort of wispy cloud shape that trails to the bottom of the page. Okay. So you can see I'm just adding a little bit of yellow now, just around the outside of the green to help it blend smoother. Just reminding myself to wet my brush so that I can blend the edges out a bit more. Okay. So you'll see as we come down to the bottom, there's going to be yellow, then orange, and hopefully red as well. Colours don't quite match my printout exactly, but that's not too bad. As long as they're roughly similar, I'm quite happy. And you can called it poetic lessons, I suppose. Okay. So here is the orange coming in. And I've mixed a little bit of the yellow in with it. Again, to make it a bit more seamless. Is a little bit more narrow than the top part, and as I said, I will widen it out later on. For now, I just want to get the colours on there. Okay. Just a touch more yellow, I think. And let's start to bleed that orange in. It's very vibrant. So here it started to look a little bit, I guess you could call it a dirty orange, which I didn't want. I do find that when you start to blend oranges, that sometimes, especially with certain acrylic reds, it can look kind of muddy. So you'll see down the bottom, I added my red, and I'm now just going over some of the colours while the bottom dries to add more vibrancy. So you should see a more dramatic difference in the background as the video progresses. Okay, so just mixing in my acrylics, and I'm making them a little bit thicker, again to add to the intensity. Green. So, okay. I'm also widening the area that I wanted to paint as well. So, I'm just slowly adding colour to it. We've gone from blue to a kind of tealy green into the more yellowy greens. And just add the brighter one down the bottom, just to blend it in. So even that little bit is starting to make it stand out. Okay. Just moving down slowly. The key is to add it bit by bit and not to rush this process. So I'm going to let this layer dry now. And then you'll see me add the more intense colours over the top. Okay. So here we have it. It's a lot more intense. And I also added my colours to a spray bottle and used them to spray over the background to give it more texture. So you'll see this mainly at the top. So to create my circles, I simply used a glass with some neat acrylic and pressed it onto my paper. And these are going to be the guidelines for my chakra symbols. So, in my head, I wanted to display them less in a sequence and more like a dream catcher. So you'll get a better idea later once I've popped all the circles on the background. It'll make much more sense, I promise. So at the moment, I'm just neatening up where the circle is and making it a little bit thicker and more defined. Very careful. Try my best not to lean on it. And I'm using one of my thinnest brushes. I really want the circles and the symbols themselves to be much more bold and intense, as they are going to be the focal point of this piece. So I'm just going to work my way slowly down the page with a slightly smaller glass. Okay. So now we've got all of our colours in, and I have changed my page over so I can get a better idea of which symbols go where and how to paint them. Okay. So let's see, we have them all here, and they will all correspond to a circle on here. I'm using a slightly thicker paintbrush for this, but it is quite stiff, so I do get some good control. Let's start with the top one, and I'm only using the pencil lightly because I don't want to leave too much of a mark, but it just gives me a decent guideline for where to paint, and if I feel confident, I may paint the rest freehand. Let's have a little look. My outline drawn in. And let's paint the symbol. So again, I'm using the same intense colour that I used for the ring, for the actual symbol itself as well, so it all matches. And hopefully it stands out that much better as well. Trying to keep it fairly simple. I don't want to overcomplicate it. So I am literally using the very simplified symbols that are on my printout. Okay. This is pretty much the similar technique that I use for the rest of them. So I'm just finishing the bottom one now. Okay. So overall, I'm pretty happy with how they turned out. However, the yellow and the orange weren't as vibrant as I would have liked. And this is where the colouring pencils come in handy. So what I did was, once I was happy with my symbols and all the extra bits I'd painted, I let it dry again, and I used my very pigmented colouring pencils to draw on details and to just shade them in a tiny bit. At this stage, I'm just using a very pale yellow pencil, and this is to draw in the lines for my dream catcher. Okay, so these are going to be guidelines again, as I'm going to paint over the top. And I decided to go with a gold theme for this one. When I'm painting details for pieces, I do prefer to use silver, but in this case I think gold matched a lot better and was more in keeping with the piece that I was trying to create. Very subtle, and again using my tiny brush, just to connect them. This is a mix of children's gold poster paint and the yellow Pebbio Studio acrylic I was using earlier to give it some body and make the gold stand out a little bit more. I also use this gold, as you can see, around the painting itself, just to give it some extra detail and sparkle. Okay, so just dotting it on very haphazardly around the backdrop. May have gone a little bit overboard with the dots. I just couldn't help myself. Okay. So again, just let those dry, and then I'm going to work over it with my colouring pencils. Okay, so before I do anything else, I'm just going to add my feathers at the bottom, because what dream catcher wouldn't be complete without some feathers? Okay, so for the details, I'm trying to match the colours to the symbols. So here I used a yellow and a white colouring pencil to get the basic shape in, and then I used a vibrant red to add the details. So from afar you probably won't be able to see it very much, but if you walked past this piece on the wall, you'd then start to see details emerging. Okay, so again, trying to keep it fairly subtle. So I've added a few more. I have my green and my yellow ones hanging down, so it's much more dreamcatcher like. And this is our finished piece. So it's much more intense with the colouring pencils over the top, as you can see by the yellows and the oranges. So, overall, I was very happy with this, and I want to thank you guys, as always, for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye-byes.